Good evening, BookTube. This is Johnny. Hope you're having a good night. This is a Tuesday night here in West Michigan. It is April the 24th. April the 24th. It is 8:20 at night. My wife left. My wife usually leaves for work for about 10 to 8. She works from 8 to 8. She works 12-hour shifts. She's a rapid response nurse. And hopefully the year 2019 she'll retire. But we'll wait and see. I'm having a cup of tea. And I mentioned last night that I wanted to show in this video, my next video, the books that I have bought at thrift stores today and last week. So I can put them down on the lower level, get them out of the living room. So yeah, first of all, today I mentioned last night I had my yearly physical this afternoon, and I'm doing fine. I'm healthy. Everything is doing great. I haven't gained any weight since last year. So yeah, and then I left early to go to the doctor's, and I went to Zealand and got bird food, cracked corn, sunflower seeds. And then I visited a thrift store there in Zealand, and I found just one book. I like books. I don't know. I kind of collect books on the Supreme Court. I don't know why. But it always interests me, these major Supreme Court decisions on, like, abortion, civil rights, and things like that. Anyway, I found this book, Becoming Justice Blackmun, Harry Blackmun Mun's Supreme Court Journey. He was Supreme Court Justice from 1970 to 1994. He was born in 1908 and he died in 1999. Wrote numerous landmark decisions, including Roe versus Wade, which is the abortion, and participated in the most contentious debates of his era, all behind closed doors. So, I don't know. This was a New York notable book. And it looked interesting. It was 53 cents. And then I went to my doctor's appointment. I got out around 4 o'clock and I stopped at Salvation Army. And I didn't find anything. I stopped at a Goodwill. That's right. I stopped at a Goodwill. I didn't find anything. And then I went to a Salvation Army. And I just found a novel by Lionel Trilling. He says here, Lionel Trilling, a critic of international reputation, and at his death, university professor emeritus at Columbia University, wielded enormous influence in the intellectual world, employing a wide range of disciplines, literature, history, philosophy, psychology. He captured the ideas of our era in a series of lucid, thought-provoking essays. I have his essays. His book linked critical studies of Matthew Arnold and E.M. Foster, as well as volumes of collected essays, The Liberal Imagination, which I have, The Opposing Self, Beyond Culture, and his final book, Serenity, Sincerity, and Authenticity. Dr. Trilling was married in 1929 to literary critic Diana Trilling. He died in 1975. And this is his novel, his only novel. So I found that. It was only like a dollar. And then I went to Bibles to Mexico, and I didn't really find anything, but I bought this because it was only like 50, 63 cents. It's a memoir of the bass player from the band Guns N' Roses. I was never really into the music with Guns N' Roses, but I kind of know about them. And this guy, he writes for the SeattleWeekly.com, ESPN.com. He lives in Seattle, but this is a memoir of, he is the bass player, I think, in the Guns N' Roses, or was in Guns N' Roses. I think he's still in Guns N' Roses. So it's called It's So Easy and Other Lies by Duff McKagan. So I got those today. Before I show the other thrift store books, I read at the, while I was waiting at the doctor's office, I read some more Under a Major Domino Minor by Patrick DeWitt. And I read this evening The Fallen, a Quinn Colson novel by Ace Atkins. This morning I read Introducing Medieval Biblical Interpretation, The Senses of Scripture and Premodern Exegesis by Ian Christopher Levy. And I've been reading tonight, Militant Grace, Apocalyptic Turn and the Future of Christian Theology by Philip P. Zingler. So I got these rest of the thrift, well, I'll show you the books I got at the Book Nook. Today is Tuesday. Monday, I got this at the Book Nook, the library used bookstore. This is by Richard Fanagan. He's an Australian writer, I believe. And I collect his writings. This is his Ghoul's Book of Fish, a novel in 12 Fish by Richard Fanagan. He wrote a couple of novels I have in my library. I think he won a Man Booker Prize. Yeah, he wrote Death of a River Guide, which I have. He was born in Tasmania in 1961. But I found this for a dollar at the Book Nook. And then I found these at the Book Nook. This completes my series, The Commander. The Commander and the Aubrey Murren novels in order of publication. So this completes my set. This is Patrick O'Brien, Desolation Island, and Patrick O'Brien, The Manitoulis Command. So now I have all, I think there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. I have all 20 of them now of this series, which I have not read, but I have them. And then at thrift stores last week, I found three novellas by Jim Harrison. I have almost all of his writings. I think about this stack, about 20 of his novels, short stories. Jim Harrison, The River Swimmer. And then I found a book of poetry by John Berryman, Selected Poems, 1937 to 1971. That's when he was younger. This is when he is older. John Berryman was the same time as Robert Lowell and Elizabeth Bishop. I have his 27 Dream Songs. I have biography by John Berryman. I like to read poetry once in a while. Then I found a book that I have already, but I didn't know, Careless People, Murder, Mayhem, and the Invention of the Great Gatsby by Sarah Churchwell. I didn't know I had this already. I'll take this to the Book Nook Friday. And then I found this at another Bible to Mexico store. This is History, How Rome Fell. It's called How Rome Fell, The Death of a Superpower by Adrian Goldsworthy. So I found this, How Rome Fell by Alan Goldsworthy. Oh, I also found Selected Essays of R.P. Blackmer, edited introduction by Dennis Donahue. I have a biography of Blackmore on Henry Adams, and another volume of essays by him. He was a literary critic. He wrote essays, like in here you have essays on Hart Crane, William Wallace Stevens, Henry Adams, T.S. Eliot, Emily Dickinson, Henry James. So I got that. So Jim Harrison, The River Swimmer, poetry by John Berryman, a novel by a very well-known Australian writer, Richard Flanagan, Gould's Fish, Book of Fish, a novel in 12 Fish. So you open it up and there's fishes there and fishes in the back. So those are the books I got at thrift stores, books I'm reading. So that's it. Now I can put these down on the lower level. And I don't know if I might visit a thrift store tomorrow. It depends upon the weather. It's called Ditto's. But I don't have anything coming in the mail until the 1st of May. And I got CDs coming in the mail. Oh, I did buy a book I got coming in the mail tomorrow. I forgot. I won't tell you what the book is about, but I'll show it to you in my next video. I ordered this book I came across. I'll just tell you it's about the city of London in England. I had this kind of fascination with like New York City, New York, Paris, France, and London, England. And I don't know why I don't go visit those places. I have the money, I have the time. I just don't like traveling. Like when I saw my doctor today, he knows about my anxiety, that I don't like leaving the house. I like being here with my books and writing in my diary and drinking tea and watching the birds and praying and reading the Bible. Did I show you that I got another Bible too last week? I found this Bible at Bibles to Mexico. This is a New American Standard. Did I show this? Now I have three Bibles. Well, I have four Bibles right here besides my place where I sit. Yeah, I got a New American Standard. This is a New Standard version. This came out in 1901. I like this because it's clean. There's no red letter. So I got that. Every time I go to thrift stores, I look for Bibles. I won't get a Bible if it's written in like somebody's birthday or anniversary or family history. If it's marked up, I won't buy it. If it's ripped or falling apart. But if it's in good condition, like this one I bought. This is a really nice little one. This one came out in, this is an Oxford. This one came out a long time ago. It's all brown. But, nice little Bible. So, yeah. So tonight, I plan to read Millicent Grace, the apocalyptic turn and future of Christian theology. So I'll sign off. Thank you for the new subscribers. Thank you for the comments. And I don't really have anything else to say. There's nothing pressing on my mind. I'm glad that doctor's appointment's over. So tomorrow is a Wednesday. I can just drift through the day. And yeah. So until next time, bye.